Let me tell you about Cursed. When something gets run over on this road, it comes back to life.
Zombie Roadkill is our latest series. We're really excited about it because it combines humor and scares, which is, I think, perfect.
Zombie Roadkill was pitched to me by David Green, our director, about 3 years ago. I knew David from working on Spider-Man 3, and he had this crazy idea of doing a show about animals coming back to life and puppets, and it sounded crazy to me.
Zombie Roadkill was going to be a short film that I was going to direct, and then we did some test footage that was just a 60-second clip of a squirrel attacking someone in the back of a parking lot, and delivered it to Ghost House, and they got excited about it.
This is probably the first zombie puppet movie.
You.
I play Simon here at Zombie Roadkill, the story of five teenagers are up on this road.
I play Amber. She's definitely the party girl of the group, and she is with Greg.
My name's Michael Blakelock, and I play Greg. He's kind of like the meathead frat guy who is pretty much, I'm out for my own ass.
They're kind of like a douchebag couple.
It says if you don't know the color of my eyes, you only want one thing.
Two things, actually.
I play the role of Trish, and my boyfriend's little brother is with us as well, who also just happens to have a crush on me.
Hey, little dude, how do you express your sexual pleasure?
With Kleenex and Vaseline. Right, Simon?
They're all a little bit douchey, and that's why when everything comes and hits them, I don't think you mind it.
All of a sudden, we get attacked by a zombie squirrel.
That's where Thomas, park ranger Chet Masterson, comes in, and tries to make sure that we're all safe.
No need to thank me, son. I'm a ranger.
This is Evil Dead and Pet Cemetery. I mean, that's the kind of vibe I got. Designing realistic animals is very difficult because if you don't do a good job, then you start looking like a stuffed animal that you buy at Toys R Us.
Bloody hands, occupational hazard.
Oh, the puppets are so freaky looking.
They're real. They're real animals.
I think here's the rabbit ash, and here's the skunk guts, and it's just a beautiful job the makeup artists have done.
We had a lot of creatures and animals, and we had a lot of actors, and we had nighttime and daytime photography, we had green screen, we had car accidents. It was a lot to put together, but just seeing it all assembled, that's really exciting.
What's going on with these freaking animals?
We're shooting in a really scary place right now, and I think those are real coyotes.
We started here Halloween, and we realized they were actually on a hillside right beside us, a little bit closer to home than we wanted.
We had all our animals laid out on this gurney, and someone looked over and said, that looks like a coyote buffet.
And just tell me if anything comes from behind me.